Yo guys, it's your boy Rob the Rider, and this is a new series I've never done before, and this is a theme park review. And today's theme park we're going to be reviewing is California's Great America. This is my home park. I've had this home park for about 3 years. I've lived in California. I've only been to it this year because I've only been an enthusiast this year. So, obviously, this park is located in Northern California near the Santa Clara area. And when you look at it, it looks like kind of a small park. And it is true. When you get in there, there's not too many rides compared to like King's Island, King's Dominion, Carowinds, or any of those parks. But I am impressed with the ride lineup because it does have, you know, Flight Deck and Gold Striker and Railblazer. And those are three pretty good rides there. But first, I have a category. So my first category is the food. And I'm going to give this category, well, I'll say what I have to say first. So the food at this park is not very good. They do not really have really any good food options except the Subway and the Panda Express. I think I'm going to California's Great America today, guys. So if I post this video today and you're watching it and if you're in the California's Great America area, meet me at the theme park. Yeah, I'm going to be going at like 5 or 6 o'clock. So if you want to meet me, please don't kidnap me. please don't kidnap me. I have bodyguards, guys. I'm not famous. But you can't kidnap me. My butler named, I don't have a butler. I don't have bodyguards. Okay. My jokes aren't funny. But the food here, not very good at all, except the Subway and the Panda Express. I'd rate the food a 3 out of 10. Okay, guys, coming into the next category, and this is the staff. And staff here have been pretty nice. I have met some mean ones, but most of them are pretty cool. And I haven't met any coaster enthusiast staff here, but pretty basic category. I'd rate the staff a 8 out of 10. Okay, guys, coming in at the next category is the ride lineup. And I think this has a pretty good ride lineup, as I said. Not the greatest, but it does have an RMC Raptor. It does have, it does have a GCI. Some people's favorite GCI. I would not agree with that, but it is a very good GCI. Probably I have a bias because, you know, I've ridden it so much, and I'll ride it today. I don't know why I just said that. But it also has Flight Deck, a pretty good 25-year-old invert. That's pretty old. But yeah, so, this ride is now defunct, you're seeing on the screen, but I'd rate the ride lineup a 7 out of 10. Okay, guys, so now we're going to be giving our overall score on this park, and I do not do what Coaster Studios does and, like, average up the scores, because then I think it'd get a little lower than I think it actually is. So you have to take into account all the accounts of this park, how it's pretty small, how it doesn't have that one standout ride besides, you know, now it's Gold Striker and Railblazer. But it doesn't have that ride that's like, wow, like you think of King's Dominion, you think of, I-305, Intimidator 305, or, you know, Twisted Timbers. And if you think of Cedar Point, you think of Dragster, Maverick, Steel Vengeance, you know, Millennium Force, stuff like that. You know, you think of King's Island, you think of Banshee, you think of Beast, you think of Mystic Timbers, Diamondback, yep. Diamondback the DB, and I'm hyper sorry my mom is talking, so hopefully you're not hearing my mom in the background. Shout out to my mom. But, you know, it's my park review. But, So this doesn't really have that crazy standout ride. Hopefully in 2020 we'll be seeing that B&M Hyper. I would honestly like I'd like a B&M Hyper over a B&M Giga, and there's only one reason why I think that. I don't think a B&M Giga will ever come to California's Great America, but I really want a B&M Hyper over B&M Giga because B&M Gigas, I like some B&M Hypers over B&M Gigas. For example, I like Shambhala at Port Aventura way more than Fury 325 at Carowinds. So I'd really prefer a good Hyper rather than a good Giga. So yeah. So if I was going to add the final score, I think this park will be receiving a 7 out of 10. And I think this is a pretty fair score. This is a pretty small theme park, and I think this is a pretty generous score. But I am a little glad I have this as my home park because, you know, it has, you know, RMC Raptor and has a lot of future. And it has, like, you know, a lot in store for its future. So thank you guys for watching this video. I love all the support you guys are giving me. 17 subscribers. Hopefully we can get to 20 subscribers by the end of the month. That would be amazing. And thank you guys for watching. And keep riding. Bye, guys.